Here we have acid dissociation, and we want to know the acid dissociation constant. We have 0.2 molar formic acid solution, where this is formic acid, and the pH is 2.74. For this reaction now, what is the acid dissociation constant? Which is essentially what is the equilibrium constant, that we have to be a little careful how we use that. Let's rewrite the reaction. And now let's add information that we know. So we start 0.020 molar. And of course the rest is water, so this is a very high number. We're given the pH. So the pH is equal to the log, this is the base 10 of the acid concentration. And this is 2.74, so that means we can take exponential both sides. So I need to be a little more careful. I left out the minus sign here. So pH is minus the log, so that means this is minus 2.74. It means I now have this concentration, 0.0182. And so how would I do this? Well, let me write this here. Because this is at equilibrium, we started out, we added this. This is going to be essentially constant. And we're going to assume now, let's do this, minus some amount x. That's going to then show up here. And so x is 0.00182. So that means the concentration of this formate ion, 0.00182, and then this concentration 0.20 minus 0.00182. So we have all three concentrations, and again the water concentration essentially doesn't change, and so it doesn't enter into this acid dissociation constant the way it's normally used. So I just done this calculation, I can write Ka, which is the product concentrations over formic acid concentration at equilibrium for all these values. Again, we don't include water because it's not changing, and this is the way that we define this acid dissociation constant. So we can substitute these numbers. This is squared over 0.0182. Now you end up with an acid dissociation constant of 1.8 times 10 to the minus 4.